Welcome to the 2023 USCA AC National Championships. Tom and Loretta Cooper are your tournament directors. Johnny Mitchell is the tournament manager. And Bryan Hovis is back on the camera doing the videography. I want to thank again for their generous sponsorship, Chris Barley and Stuart Price. And we are, of course, the official YouTube channel of the USCA, which provides sponsorship as well. Check it out. Think about signing up and join us on the croquet lawn. This is the first flight block game between Arlene Parker from Ontario with a grade of 1369. She plays pretty much exclusively AC because she's from Canada. And she's taking on Jeff Morrison, a Floridian who's a member of the NCC, at 12:15. I don't know who chose what, but Arlene was supposed to play red. They recognize that a mistake was made and recruit David Malouf, former second in the World Championships, on this lawn, actually, to explain to him what to do. Basically, she has to take her proper ball and put it on a balk line anywhere she wants to, and then he plays second with the ball of his choice. Most folks put this on the corner spot in corner three, as far away from the action as possible. Out there on the end of the balk line, it lets him get a rush on it in turn two and do something more useful with it. He's going to put red essentially in super shot position. So blue should go where you would respond to a super shot, either in corner two or maybe maximum distance on the east boundary. This position functions as a tice and really gives her a big advantage. Her mallet is made by her fellow Canadian, Bryan Cumming, and I'm sure he's taking a little bit of credit for the fact that she is such a good shot.
She okay is everything in the world. I should put it over there.
She's going to point her rush appropriately toward the north boundary so she can pick up that ball up by hoop two. Which will further take advantage of the fact that he's going to shoot at blue, I guess because it's the shortest shot, but I would have thought about shooting at one of her balls and going into corner four. Because a miss here gives her those two balls to work with to build a break. Thank you. disadvantage of making hoop one off opponent, you set up a laid break, which they now get if you bounce off hoop one.
How you doing?
Doing well.
Good.
Good to see you.
What are you doing here?
Video.
Good. On whose request?
USCA's.
Oh, really?
Huh?
Okay. They specifically wanted you to come over here and do this is the first flight, you know.
Yes.
Not the championship flight.
Correct.
Okay. Why would anybody want to see the first flight? We're no good. Those guys over there, they're really good.
My good friend Mike Todorovich being self-deprecating. In fact, we get really good feedback from games like this that people can learn from.
Good morning, Sandy. How you doing?
cashier 12:15 with your account. That was me. Tails, please. Just went.
You've heard me say this a dozen times. She's going to hit a roll shot here because she wants to be careful about getting red in position. But her break would be better served with a nice drive or stop shot that puts yellow further down so she gets a good rush toward blue at hoop six, because blue's not a great pioneer. Thank you. She's an experienced AC player. She knows to put yellow in pioneer position at two back so it doesn't end up at three back. That has to do with the diagonal spread she's probably going to try to set. Nice. Blues at the peg for the diagonal spread. He got a nice rush on black for one back. And with such a good two-back pioneer, the leave is coming together. She is such a good shot that that has to be classified as a mental error. Jeff gets a lift because Arlene just made one back, and with perfect pioneers at one and two, he can get going here. Thank you. He's probably thinking defensively here. He doesn't want black near red in case he breaks down, but be better off being confident that he's going to get it done. Leave black pretty much where it was, so it's a great hoop two pioneer. And take off from there to the yellow ball at hoop one.
Too short the first time, too long the second time.
I think that was a miss hit. I'm not sure. She might be better off with a big roll shot here. Because when you set a leave out in the middle of the lawn, you have to be pretty careful not to leave a double target. And with yellow as far from red as it is, that's tough to do. A little bit of a trap leave so that if black shoots at him, yellow can pick up black. Thank you. Bob and Ted discourage rushing pioneers, especially so far. But in this case, she has to pick up blue over there on the boundary. And I think this approach is the right one, especially if you can do that. Because now it's going to be safer for her to approach blue from a much narrower angle. Had she tried to do a split shot that put her on blue from around hoop two, she would have risked going out of bounds next to blue. Since she doesn't really have a good hoop six pioneer, she could have considered trying to double load six with black here. But there's a lot of furniture in the way of doing that. Thank you. So Arlene on the second break makes five. Has a substantial lead, but leaves Jeff with all the balls together. Despite having all the balls, Jeff couldn't get going. There were several turns of back and forth. And we jump ahead to our opponents positioned in opposite corners from each other. She did this multiple times during this game. Has a great feel for the speed of the lawn.
I didn't mean to distract you. I got to stop.
You're playing fantastic. I'm just, you know.
Yellow's in corner three, red's basically in corner one. It's going to take some precise croquet to get a break out of this. Here comes the Zach Watson shot. 7 yard roll up, 90 degrees to the approach line to the hoop. Opponent ball 3 feet away. What, me worry? Thank you. This is a good idea. Use the takeoff here and leave red as a pioneer in hoop two. Go dig yellow out of corner three and put it out on the lawn where it's useful to you. Then go back to black, which is all set to make hoop one and get a break going. He is good at those roll-ups. He's going to play for the rush on red, I think, but maybe he should have just gone to black now so that he had two shots to get a nice, precise setup at hoop one with a trap and a rush for black to hoop one. Blue and black are both, of course, at red's hoop, but red and yellow are far enough apart that this should be safe. Well, it should have been safe. She is not leaving him any place to hide. Everybody learns in their first one or two AC games that when she bounces off the hoop here, going through and setting up for two back wired from black would be a bad idea, because then blue and black just join up and you lose the innings. There would have been an even worse idea, because hoop one was black's hoop. All black had to do was shoot the hoop. Speaking of which, the big boys, of course, would have roquet blue, done a split shot, sending blue toward two and getting a good hoop shot on one, maybe a two-ball break going. But he can still do some damage here if he roquets blue and goes and repositions opponent. Thank you. After bothering the Roquet Red, most folks would have split it out onto the lawn for later use. But this is a first-class rush. He got away with it earlier, so he's gonna do another Zach Washington style roll up from 3 miles away. Even Zach Watson only gets this done one time in 50, though. I think he'd be better off to stop shot yellow in a good pioneer position at two, and then get a very precise rush between blue and black. Maybe aiming at blue's hoop, maybe aiming either one of the balls toward corner one, which is probably where yellow's going to go. And if he does that, then yellow and red can't join up. I think thinking through it like that is what Wiley calls canny croquet, where you try to do leaves that paralyze your opponent and give you multiple opportunities. He's going to give blue a rush to its hoop four rather than attack. A good way to do that is to roll them both out of bounds at the same time. That way they're both on the yard line and you're guaranteed a good rush. This way is going to be more of a cut rush than he wanted. I assume if blue had landed closer to six, she would have gone ahead and made it with yellow. But she's got a lead, and she's more interested in setting good leaves. Blue is right in front of its own hoop, though.
there. I mean, that, you know, gives me one wicket, but I appreciate it.
Oh, well, you're welcome. I think you're wired. Okay. Sweet.
Thank you.
Thank you.
He could position blue on the other side of the hoop so that when he makes two with black, he can rush blue back south to red on the boundary, pick up yellow, and go to three and get a four-ball break. So he's going to try for the break, but it's going to be a three-ball break now. And maybe he was just trying to keep blues in a safe place while he tried this maneuver. As my grandson likes to say, 1, 2, skip a few, 99, 100. So there was more of this for a few turns. And we join back up with Arlene on the attack again. And the board unchanged. Black's an okay two-back pioneer, but it's also close to A-bonk. Keep that in mind.
There's no question.
The reward is high. But the risk was higher. I think I said earlier, I wonder how much credit Bryan Cummings takes for her incredible shooting. She is putting on a real showcase for his mallet. She wants to make one back on her next turn. He could put black like a foot south of the corner three corner spot. Then if she doesn't get it out of there and he gets a lift, he'll have a rush on that ball. She wouldn't fall for it, of course, but she has to expend the time and opportunity going to get that ball. She probably wanted red to go farther because it's pretty vulnerable to a shot from the B balk line. This is a little awkward. If she doesn't make two back and keep going, blue has a pioneer and black at its hoop five, and red within striking distance from B bog. Not what she intended, I'm sure. And now he's going to have a double target if he wants it. Jeff's down by 9 hoops. But there are 8 hoops between him and the peg. He can make a contest out of this. Don't be silly, you say. He's going to go through 3 back and settle leave. Maybe. But she's such a good shot that she has a good chance of hitting in no matter what leave he presents to her. So going to peg, not pegging out, of course, but setting a good contact leave might not be a bad tactical choice, because in first flight players don't have much experience with contact leaves, and contact leaves are challenging anyway. Of course, this is a time-limited game, so if he goes to a contact leave 1 hoop behind, he might never get another chance to make a hoop. you've noticed, of course, that it, now he doesn't have a one-back Pioneer. But there's a little MacGyver in this guy. I would have rushed red to the right, his right of black, 3 or 4 yards now, sent red to 2 back, and then made 1 back off black. Looks like he's thinking about setting up the diagonal spread now. I don't know. I think the Pioneer might take priority over that. He really needs a rush toward yellow on black after 1 back. He's made 1 back, so Arlene gets a lift. He's going to have to make 2 back off red, which is by the peg. And his partner ball black is more or less his Pioneer at 3 back. It's going to be challenging to turn this into a leave that has a name. Thank you. I'd be interested in any options people want to put in the comments, but I think his best bet here is basically an old standard leave. Maybe even leave red right where it is. Go make three back off yellow. Stick yellow down by hoop three someplace, and then get black and blue out of bounds between the corner and hoop four on the east boundary. There's no point in trying to cobble together a diagonal spread from this. Even this would work. He could make three back and then do a wide join in corner four on the boundary. I would roll them both out of bounds, about 3 yards apart on the east boundary near corner four. So, a nice little break from 5 to 3 back, cobbled together with some clever shots. A somewhat haphazard leave, however. It gives Arlene a number of choices and little opportunity for him if she misses. And she didn't even need the lift to take the shot she wanted. Jeff gets a lift to balk when she finishes, so looks like she's working on the lead before she runs out of hoops. Somewhat unusual place to put blue, unless she's going to do a Patel. Samir Patel, the English player, has revived the lead where you park an opponent ball behind hoop one, hidden from A-bog. Nah, she's not going to do that. Oh my goodness, she forgot about the lift. And that's a way better explanation for Blue's position than a Patel leave. Well, this leave is not haphazard, it was very intentional, but it's giving Jeff all kinds of opportunities because she forgot that he got a hoop lift.
That's not a gimme.
And he'll never tell whether he was shooting at yellow or aiming between those two balls. He left her a double and she missed it. There is still hope. And now, once again, he's 8 behind, but there are 9 hoops between him and the peg. Correctly playing black. He could still win this. Red is wired from all 3 balls, but it's exactly where she put it when she ended her last turn, and he didn't move it when he hit yellow from the end of A box. So. No lift. That was pretty cool. It gives them the opportunity to set a trap, leave black right where it is, put blue a foot or two north, making sure that yellow doesn't have a double target. Then if yellow shoots and misses, black can pick it up and get a break going. Black still can make plenty of hoops to win this game. This thing is not over. He needs to come through hard, go out of bounds, pick up yellow, and have a three-ball break. But American rules instincts are hard to overcome sometimes. Arlene Parker shoots lights out. She's tactically sound and runs a nice break. I'm surprised her grade is only in the 1300s. I'm not surprised, spoiler alert, that she won this game and met Linda Sutterberg in the first flight finals, which had the lovely distinction of being the first time that two women had competed for the first flight USCA AC Championship. I think we may have a snippet or two of that game. Unfortunately, it was being played at the same time as the championship flight final, so Bryan wasn't able to cover it. The highlight of my playing career so far, in addition to pushing Tom Balling to 25-26, was winning first flight doubles and singles in the AC Championships at Mission Hills in 2016, I think. So Jeff Morrison had his chances, and he pushed her pretty hard. But Arlene's spectacular shooting, tactical soundness, and break running proficiency allowed her to prevail 26-14 in this block game. As I said, she went on to play Linda Sutterberg in the first all-female first flight USCA AC National Championships. So give us a like, subscribe, hit that notification bell. We got the three-game series championship final between Matthew Essick and Zach Watson coming up. Thanks, as always, to the USCA, Chris Barley, and Stuart Price for their generous sponsorship. I know this game's a little long. Really long, actually, and I did cut out over 35 minutes. But there's a lot in here, and at the very least, Arlene Parker will watch it from beginning to end, maybe more than once.
About that, but you're welcome.